Now the next film that you see are the film that we took of a Polaris launch, and there it comes. This was quite an impressive sight. We saw the Polaris pop right out of the Atlantic at exactly the point it was supposed to be, and we were able to track it very well. I might add that this Polaris was fired by the submarine Benjamin Franklin. It was the first time they'd ever fired a Polaris, and they were able to do it at the exact second it was programmed. And now you see as it starts to fade in as it's silhouetted against the clouds. Well, after that much of the powered flight and the insertion, Jim and I settled down to approximately 2 weeks, and he'll describe the 2 weeks.
Thanks a lot, Frank. I would like to talk about the rendezvous, but I'd be shot.
Well, let's see, the rendezvous, along about the 10th day, coming out of the...
Nine. We have ignition sequence start. The engines are on. 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. We have commit. We have
liftoff.
Liftoff at 7:51 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. We are clear to tower.
Roger. How do you hear you, sir?
Mark one Charlie, boy. 1B, staging status, mister.
What
we thought we'd do today was just show you a little bit about life inside Apollo 8. We've shown you the scenes of the moon, scenes of the Earth, and we thought we'd invite you into our home.
Do you look up at the moon a little differently than the rest of us, or do you?
Sometimes I do. I try to. I try to feel like everybody thinks I should.
Which is?
Which is an awe. I can't believe I was really there. And sometimes I do, but most often, I just revel in a beautiful moon.